Friends, I am Mr. D. J. Doshi, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Learning outcome of this video is, at the end of this session, students will be able to understand different types of riveting and its applications. Content in this video are introduction and definition of riveting, types of riveting, advantages and limitations of riveting, and application of riveting. Now, definition about this riveting is, a rivet is a permanent mechanical fastener. A rivet consists of a smooth cylindrical shaft with a head on one end. The end opposite to the head is called as the tail. To distinguish between the two ends of the rivet, the original head is called as factory head and the deformed end is called as shop head or bucktail. Types of riveting. Various types of head for large rivets used are snapper cup head, pan head, countersink head, half countersink head, conical head formed by hand hammering, and conical head. If you observe the sketches, first one is snapper cup head. The head shape is not actual semicircular, but it is curved shape which is used for riveting. So this is head, whereas other part of this is called as tail or bucktail, which is hammered to hold the two work pieces or two plates with each other. Second one is pan head. If you observe, this shape of the head is like a pan. So this pan head is head, whereas the tail, again as I told, will be hammered to hold the two work pieces. Third one is countersink head. So this, if you observe head shape, this is like a countersink. When we carry out countersinking on the plate, the shape of the countersink will be like this. So countersink head, head is like this, and another one is tail, which is hammered similarly. Half countersink head. So this is half countersink. This countersinking is at half side, whereas another half will be flat one. So that is called half countersink head. Fifth one is conical head formed by hand hammering. So this part is conical shaped, which is formed by hand hammering. Whereas next one is conical head. So this is sharp corner head, which is called as conical head. The purpose of each type of head is different. So this snapper cup head is used where there is extension or extended portion on the plate, which should not injure anybody. Then this type of shape is used, and this is not a semicircular one. In case of pan head, again purpose of pan head is, this will be the extended part or the part on the plate. So wherever this type of head is required, we should not injure the persons who are handling the material, the pan type of head is used. It has a more grip than the snapper cup head. Whereas countersink head, sometimes we need to fabricate two work pieces or two plates where there should not be any portion outside above the face of the surface or face of the plate or of surface of the plate. So the countersinking is carried out on one plate, which will be of the same shape of the countersink head. In this case, when we complete the riveting, the fabricated portion, there will not be any extension or any part which is coming out of the face of the component or plate. Half countersink head. The purpose of half countersink head is to lock the head from rotating. So when we put it and hammer it, the half countersink part will be set on the plate such that this rivet will not rotate along its own axis. Conical head formed by hammering. So this head is formed with the help of hammering, and this will again will not cause any injury to the persons who are handling. Whereas conical head, if you observe, it has a sharp corner on all the three sides, but it will get more surface on the plate to contact, and there will be sharp edge so that there should not be any movement on that part by the people or by the animals or by the handling persons. Now pause the video and answer this question. In rivets, the deformed end is called as. Now you might have written the answer. The answer of this question is, the deformed end is called as shop head or bucktail. Now types of riveting. Various types of head for small rivets: truss or wagon head, button head, flat head, pass head, and countersink head. So if you observe these figures, truss or wagon head is similar to the head which we studied under the heavy component riveting. Button head, again it is also same as the last case. Flat head, it has a curved surface given on the side, but the above surface is flat, which will be accommodated in the countersink provided or the step drilling provided on the plate, so it will not extend out of the plate surface. Pan head, again it is the shape of a pan, same thing. And countersink head, again it is also discussed during last part of this video. Advantages and limitations of riveting. It is more reliable because it is mechanically checked that there should not be any relative movement of the plates. It can also be used for non-ferrous metals. See, the welding or gas welding processes are usually used for similar metals, and it is normally used for the metals like cast iron or mild steel. Non-ferrous metals does not have more provisions for fastening. So here riveting can be carried out by for non-ferrous metals. Now non-ferrous metal can be joined with the help of rivets. Part assembled by riveted joint do not have any thermal after effects. Now in case of welding, or in case of gas welding, or in case of spot welding, we are generating certain heat either to melt the filler metal or make it to flow the metal into the capillaries. So that changes the thermal effects of the original metal, and it may have some another effects, thermal effects on it. Its quality inspection is easy and cheap. So it is mechanically checked, physically checked, and you can check whether the riveting is carried out properly or not. When parts are dismantled, riveted parts have less damage compared to welded joints. When we want to dismantle the parts, we just have to remove the rivets by either drilling or by chipping it. So there will not be any damage of the parent metals or the metals, the metal plates which we have joined. Whereas in case of welding, it is melting the parent metal as well as the filler material. So when we dismantle those, we have to hammer it and break it out. So it will damage the surfaces in case of welding. And in case of riveting, there will not be any damage of the parent unit or parent plates which we have joined. Limitations. Due to holes, plates become weak. Now you know, for riveting, we need to drill the holes on the both the plates. So it will weaken the mechanical qualities or mechanical properties or mechanical strength of the plates when we carry out drilling. Labor cost is more. Now in this case, the precise drilling is to be carried out so that when we join two metals, those will be as per required shape. So in this case, the skilled person requires to carry out the drilling and riveting. So labor cost is comparatively more than the welding and other joining processes. Overall cost of riveted joints is more. So as the labor cost increases, again rivets are to be used. So the cost of the total joint will be more than the welded joints or other joints. Now these riveted joints have more weight than welded joints. As we are applying additional metal for riveting, the weight adds to the original weight of the material and the weight will be increased. Riveting process creates more noise. Now hammering the tail, bucktail, will cause noise, so it creates more noise for carrying out riveting. State concentration near holes. As there is a drilling operation is carried out, there will be stress concentration. So there is a chance of cutting off the piece there during regular use. application. It is used where we have to avoid after thermal effects, as in case of the welding. Used for metals which have poor weldability. Used for heterogeneous materials like asbestos, friction lining and steel. As welded joints have poor vibration damping capabilities, where required rivets are used in place of it. The reference books used for this are PL Single, a textbook of basic mechanical engineering, Tech Max publications. Thank you.